Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I want to make a review on my hand drill today. This is a very old piece and I've got really no idea what is the name of it or where it was manufactured and when. There's no whatsoever that I can find any mark or number or make on this drill, and it's got a 2-speed. Currently it's on a slow speed there, and if you remove the handle, put it there, you've got the high speed. So I'll try and demonstrate it to you now. Okay, so I'm gonna try and let me just lift it a little bit. So this is the slow speed. Okay. And then you can remove this handle. You have to, and put it in this side. And then you remove the handle. And put it on this side. You can secure it there with a screw. And now it's an high speed. I hope you can see the difference. I would say it's about 1/3 times faster. Okay, so it's in a very good condition. There's no slack on the gears, and the chuck still works nice. I believe it's maximum about 10 millimeter, but it still works. So this is a nice piece, and I often use this tool. And you can pull this out and turn it around how you find it the best or the most convenient position. So yeah, this is an old piece and it got this nice hammer tone paint on it originally. But if somebody have an idea where this stuff was made, it would be great to know, because there's really zero no idea where it came from. Okay, so this is just a short review. Okay, gents, and now a short review on a hammer that I made when I was an apprentice back in the 80s. It was one of our projects in the workshops. So we had to make this handle out of wood. And this is a piece of aluminium that you have to... firstly, you... put it in a lay and make it a nice round piece, and then mill it in this positions to make it square apart from the little round there, and then you put it in the milling machine and mill all the way that side and that side as well, same this side. And it was a meat hammer for tenderizing your steak or piece of meat or chicken or whatever. But I used this all the years as a soft hammer on my other projects. That's why it looked like it. And I'm still using it a lot. So it's very ideal to not damage your part, whatever you work with. So I thought I will just show you this. This hole was round, and then you come skew in with your drill, and that way as well. And then when you insert your spade there, you can see it flare the wood out, and now it is set in the position, and it can't go out. So this is made by myself back in the 80s when I was apprentice. Very nice piece, nice hammer to have. Okay, so I thought I will show some stuff of my olden days, what I make myself. I've got a lot of other stuff that might come up in videos. Okay, and now a review on my oil filter removal tools. This is a strap type that you can grab here with a half inch, I think, or 3/4 inch tool, and then you strap this around your oil filter, and as you wind it up, you can fasten it, or other side you loosen it. So this works well if your filter is in a nice position. So it's not a bad product. The other one is this chain type. This one is really, I was never impressed with it. I think in any case it's broken at this point in time. So these two parts come together. It's like a bicycle chain. And then there's some tooth there, and you go that way, and you can unlock it or make it loose. So again, it works okay if the filter is in a great or a very convenient position, but I was never impressed with this thing. It tends to slip. Okay, and the other piece is also a strap type. This is a better one. So you put this around your filter, and then you wedge it in that position, or in that position, so for fasten. So this one is really okay. It works well and still in a workable condition. And then I've got another one with I can't find it now. This is for a filter that you can only reach the bottom part, so it got three fingers that that grip your filter, and that one worked very nice, especially on my Mercedes, where you haven't got space for this angle. You need to work from the top side, so that one worked, but I can't find it now. It's somewhere in my toolboxes. So I've got this four, this three, and the other one, and yeah. So it's always a problem to remove filters. So you need to have a few kinds to remove and do the job, as part from driving a screwdriver right through it. It's always a mess. Okay, so this is my three removal tools, and until next time, thank you very much for watching.